In your single variable calculus courses, you have already learned a lot about functions of a real variable. In a course of complex functions, many complex learned for real functions will be generalized to the complex case. In this video, we'll encounter the first example of such a generalization. We'll learn what a complex function is and we'll introduce some notation which is commonly used. So let's go back to the real case first. So what was a real function? Well, what is a function? You have an x, and a function is a rule f which assigns to any x in the domain of the function a function value f of x. And for real functions, those domains are subsets of R, and the codomain is also a subset of R. And now we're going to generalize this. The picture for a complex function looks almost the same. Now we have a z. Our function is again a rule which assigns to any z in the domain of the function a function value f of z. So what's the difference? Only difference is now that the domain will be a subset of C and the codomain will also be a subset of C. So exactly the same ideas as for functions of real value, real functions. You have a value and the function assigns to that value another value. They used to be real and real, and now they are complex and complex. Let's use some notation now. So we often write w equals f of z instead of y equals f of x, because we'll need y for something else, because we write z equals x plus iy, where x and y are just real numbers. And we can also split w in its real and imaginary part. We call the real part of w u, and the imaginary part of w we will call it v, which both depend on x and y. So u and v, depending on x and y, are just normal functions going from R2 into R. So we can split any complex function in two real functions of two variables. So let's take a look at an example. Function f from C to C. F of z equals z squared. So what does that mean? Well, if you have a 2 plus I, for example, what will be the image of that? The image of 2 plus I will be 2 plus I squared. We can work out the brackets, so we get a 4 plus 4i plus I squared equals 4 plus 4i minus 1, so 3 plus 4i. So that's how you find the image of a number. And what if we want to split it into real and imaginary parts, well then we write w equals x plus iy squared, work out the brackets again, we get the x squared plus I squared y squared, so minus y squared, plus 2 times x times y times I. So we see that the real part u over here equals x squared minus y squared, and the imaginary part v equals 2 times x times y.